Simon & Schuster Audio presents A Value Tales Treasury, Growing Good People One Story at a Time by Spencer Johnson. Read by Danny Burstein and Kerry Washington, with a note read by the author.
Hello, my friend. You're about to hear a new kind of story called an imaginography. Like a biography, these stories are about real people and events. But imaginographies are told in a more fun and imaginative way. You'll get to see how famous people grew into the good people they wanted to become by listening to their own true voice, that special voice inside each of us that gives us our own best thoughts. Your true voice can help you too, especially when you listen to your own best thoughts and use your imagination. How powerful is your imagination? Well, listen to this. Do not think about one yellow elephant standing alone in Africa. Do not think about many yellow elephants, big ones and little baby ones, running through the jungle. Or about lots of yellow elephants drinking water out of a beautiful blue lake. Did you not think of yellow elephants? Or were you able to see them in your powerful imagination? Of course, yellow elephants don't really exist, but it can be fun to imagine them. Just like the person that you may grow into someday doesn't really exist yet either. But as you listen to these stories, you can have fun imagining, painting pictures in your mind about how you might use the same values that the five famous people you are about to meet used in their lives. Believing in yourself. Helping. Honesty. Determination. And humor, so that you can have fun growing up into the kind of person you would like to become. Your friend, Spencer Johnson.
The Value of Believing in Yourself, a value tale about Louis Pasteur.
Hello, my name is Bee Leave. I may look like an ordinary bee, but don't be fooled. You can imagine me as the true voice of a real person named Louis Pasteur, who lived more than 100 years ago. I'm a fun way for you to see how Louis may have listened to himself, his true voice, that voice inside of each of us that gives us our best thoughts. Now, when Louis was a little boy, long before he became famous, no one knew that invisible germs made people sick. One of the worst of these was called rabies. But as Louis grew up, he believed he could do what no one else thought he could. What do you think Louis Pasteur believed he could do? Well, to find out, let's begin our story together. Once upon a time, there was a boy named Louis Pasteur. As he played with his toy soldiers, he wondered what he might do when he grew up. Maybe, he thought, I might find a way to help people who are very sick. That's when I buzzed in his ear. Hello, my name is Bee Leave. Believe in yourself, Louis, and you will be able to do more than you ever thought you could. And Louis listened to me. He worked hard all through school, learning everything he could about medicine. All the while, he repeated what he had heard from me, his true voice. I believe I can, he said as he studied. I believe I can find a cure for the invisible enemy called rabies. Louis finished school and became a scientist. Many years later, he began to work on finding a cure for rabies, but others made fun of him. How silly, they said. If an enemy is invisible, then no one can find it. Sometimes Louis became sad. Maybe I can't, he admitted to himself. But then he heard a voice the laughing children did not hear. Remember, I told him, when you believe in yourself, you can do more than you might think. Louis listened to himself, smiled, and went back to work. Years after people laughed and poked fun at Louis Pasteur, a little boy in a land far away was laughing and poking a stick at a poor sick dog. The boy's name was Joey. He wasn't really a cruel little boy. He just liked to tease, as some children sometimes do. But this was not a good idea. Unlike most dogs who were friendly, this dog was so sick that white foam was coming from his mouth. Do you know what was wrong with the dog? The dog had rabies. If you were able to look inside the dog with a very powerful microscope, you would see the germs that were making him sick and mad. All of a sudden, the dog bit Joey, and the germs that were hiding in the dog traveled into the little boy. Joey became very sick, and his parents worried. Everyone knew that anyone who was bitten by a dog with rabies would most surely die. All Joey's mother could do was comfort him. But then one day she heard some very exciting news. A scientist says he has found...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.